think that it felt for the farmers?
The school year is just beginning for students and for the teacher.
Can everybody tap out the word wolf?
Amber Garcia is a first year, first grade teacher at Alderman Elementary.
If I was at any other school, my nerves would be through the roof, for sure. But I'm just so excited just to be here. I'm excited to now be a teacher. It's like everything that I worked for. So this time,
Garcia is new, but she isn't. She went to school here. Plus, Garcia's grandmother, Marie Farlow, was a teacher's assistant. And there's more to this story.
And now I have carried on the legacy, and I am working at Alderman Elementary in the exact classroom that she was teaching in, using some of the materials that she taught with.
In a way, Farlow is still a teacher's assistant. This time, she's helping her granddaughter. Garcia carries her grandmother with her in her heart, and Farlow's picture is always close.
And I had this as a reminder that no matter what troubles you're going through right now, you have to remember your ultimate goal in life and your passion, and something that she instilled in me and drove me to do was to take care of little children. So tell me again.
Teachers that worked with Farlow can see that Garcia has what it takes to be successful.
All the things that you need to be a really great teacher, but also all the things that you really need just to be a really great person. I see in Amber. She did a great job instilling those characteristics in Amber.
A fable teaches you a lesson.
Here, the second day of school, I can see that she's developed that instinct as well. Building relationships and making connections is one of the biggest parts of teaching.
Raise your hand if you've heard of a comic strip.
A lesson Garcia learned many years ago from her grandmother.
Pat, Carlos, and Israel, line up.
In Guilford County, Charles Ewing, Fox 8 News.
Now, when you were alive.
By the way, Marie Farlow was a teacher's